Welcome everyone, Dongmin here.
Thank you for joining us in our virtual concert hall. It is so wonderful to collaborate again to present our fifth concert of the season, and we are thrilled to welcome back acclaimed pianist HaeSun Paik. Today, we open the stage with Samuel Barber's iconic piece, Adagio for Strings, followed by Beethoven's second piano concerto performed by HaeSun Paik. NYCP believes in excellence in music for everyone. This is what we have done for over 10 years. All our concerts are free, and that doesn't change even though we are presenting this concert on screen instead of on stage. Our performance is made possible through the support of our board of directors, the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs, and most importantly, by generous music lovers like you. Your support is essential and keep NYCP moving forward. So we hope you will show your support by making a gift. You can give online by clicking the link in the description below. Our audience means everything to us. Thank you for listening and enjoy the concert.
Hello, I'm HaeSun Paik. Today I will play Beethoven's second piano concerto in B-flat major, which is actually his first concerto. He started to compose it when he was 16 years old, but it took over 10 years to revise it and to finish the piece. He was never really happy with the piece, and it got published much later than the first concerto. Nevertheless, this is one of my favorite early Beethoven works, and I love this piece, but it's very tricky to play. The influence of Mozart and Haydn is very apparent, but one can already detect Beethoven's typical charming or energetic spirit, but also find his profound voice. This piece reminds me so much of all-time French classic novel, The Little Prince, by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. Like this book, the concerto speaks to a child within us. The story touches us with enigmatic and innocent questions. It shows magical world of imagination and also makes us realize what is important in life. And to comparison to that, this concerto in the first movement begins with the orchestra's march-like rhythm, which resembles innocent pride and assurance. Then the piano solo enters with charming and graceful bird-like melodies with many questions which get self-answers. The cadenza at the end of the movement is composed much later, so it is more complicated with dimensional voices. But I think the second movement is the gem of this piece. It is the longest movement. For me, it is like a tender, loving song of the little prince, asking and conversing with planets for meaning of life, seeking for truth, and one can definitely hear Beethoven's true searching voices. In the third movement, one can enjoy Beethoven's typical youthful dance-like spirit with his musical and whimsical jokes. In The Little Prince, the fox teaches us, quote, "Everything that's truly important in life comes from the heart, not from one's eyes." And yes, today I would second that quote and invite all of you to listen to tonight's NYCP's performances not only with your ears, but with your heart. I hope you enjoy. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.